So I want to talk to you about Shakeology. Super Shake. You got this in your bundle, probably in a bag, but maybe you got sample packets too. Either way, the scoop equals one sample packet. How you mix it up. I know the directions on the back says mix with water. It says combine one packet with 8 to 12 ounces of water. Don't do that, friend. Let me save you. So Shakeology, what it is, it's a superfood shake. It essentially is a health food shake. It's not a protein shake. It's not a weight loss shake. You can use it as a meal replacement, but that's not necessarily the goal of it. The goal of this is to help give your body all the vitamins and nutrients that it needs to function properly. So drinking this every single day is essentially like seven salads. It is the healthiest meal of the day because it has so many vitamins and nutrients that really help your body perform at its optimal level. Can you get results without this? Of course. However, this will make your results even better. And for me, it directly impacts my mood. My family sees like depression, mental illnesses run in my family. This, when I drink this, I can tell it evens me out. It gets my levels where I need to be, keeps my body regular. So if you're having bathroom issues, maybe you're going too much or you're not going enough, this will help with that. It is great for blood pressure. It's great for all these things. I will never, ever, ever say this will fix all your problems, but I can say this will help you feel better because it's helped me. So how do we mix it up? Don't just mix it with water and powder because you will want to kill me and then you will probably want to puke. What I do is I get some ice. I always blend it. It's the best. You'll get some ice. Throw it in here. I'm making a huge, gigantic shake for the kiddos, so this is gonna be like monster shake. Yours doesn't have to be this big. Honestly, when I'm making it for myself, I'll do about 6 cubes, but since this is my monster shake for them, we're gonna put lots of cubes in. And then what I do is, I'm not a big veggie eater, so I add spinach. Why? Because spinach, when added, you don't taste. So if you're struggling with vegetables, I highly recommend you add some spinach in on your shake. This will help you get a serving of your vegetables without having to taste it. Doesn't leave any weird texture or anything like that. Then almond milk. For you, you would want to do 8 to 10 ounces of almond milk, and then you could do the rest with water. If you do more than 10 ounces, you do have to count it as a yellow. So definitely save your yellows. Obviously, this one's for my kids, so ignore the large amounts of almond milk. But that will help it be smoother, creamier. I'm a texture person, so I'm super, super picky about textures. I don't like grittiness. So it took me a little bit of time to figure out what works for me. Extracts are a plus. You could do vanilla, which is what this is. There's caramel and maple extracts. Those are really good in this. Mint or butter, but if you're using those two, a little bit goes a long way. So definitely test it out a little bit. Next, peanut butter. Peanut butter helps me so much. I love peanut butter. If you don't love peanut butter, obviously you can skip this. It's not necessary. But peanut butter helps keep that shake smooth and makes it, it just tastes so good. I just can't with peanut butter. Okay, so peanut butter. Maybe you don't love peanut butter. What else could you put in? You could put in fruits. I personally do not like to put seeded fruits in it because it gives it that grittiness taste. So for me, bananas work really well. If you want smoothness, you could also do squash. You could do avocado. It helps smooth out the flavor. I highly recommend bananas in it. Obviously, if you don't like that, don't put that in there. But it just helps with the texture. Again, flavor-wise, if you like sweet stuff, because a lot of us are so used to having such sweet things, go for sugar-free Jell-O cheesecakes, like the pudding mixes. Sugar-free pudding mixes will help give it a sweet flavor. It will taste super, super good. And then what you're going to want to do is you'll mix it up and you will get those out of my house. Life with kids. Hello, this is me as a coach. What that will do is it will help bring the flavor together, find a recipe that you like. Outside! It'll help you find a recipe that you like. Maybe you're like, I don't love shakes. I don't even want to do that. You stop yelling and go to your bedroom, please. Right now. I'm so sorry. So maybe you're like that person who doesn't want to do shakes, because that was me. I don't like to drink my food. I want to eat it. We have a cookie dough recipe. We have cookies. You could make it into a power bowl. So like ice cream or pudding, anything like that. You can adjust the ice. You can adjust the liquid. You can add granola and fruits to the top of it to make it like a power bowl. There's so many different ways that you can have it. Honestly, for me, it's like vegetables. I know I need to have them. I know my body needs them. So it's a non-negotiable. For me, this I know helps my body. I know it makes my mood better. I know it helps keep me regular. I know without it, I'm a whole different person. So for me, it's a non-negotiable. It was all about finding a recipe that allowed me to enjoy it the best. So hopefully these tips are super, super helpful. I would love to know which flavor you're using. And then when you find a recipe that you love, send it to me. I wanna hear about it. I want to know. And as you're trying it, let's say day one you try it and you didn't love it, reach out to me and say, hey, I didn't love this about it. And I will help you find solutions to the problem so that you can enjoy this. I don't ever, ever, ever want any part of this to be something that you don't love or don't enjoy. So that's it. I'll see you guys later.